My primary responsibility is to assess for hearing loss, and that could be from a baby that may not have passed the newborn hearing screening, all the way to the geriatric population where they're coming in because a family member might be concerned that they're not hearing as well. We look at evaluating the hearing and then making recommendations for a rehabilitation plan or a habilitation plan to help improve their communication. Typically, it's using hearing aids to help amplify whatever residual hearing the individual might have. Depending on the severity of the loss, hearing aids may not necessarily be the best option for the individual, in which case then we might recommend a patient go through a cochlear implant evaluation. Sometimes we also have individuals that do not have an ear, for example, or there's no ear canal opening, and so we have to determine whether or not the inner ear is functioning or the auditory nerve is functioning. And if it is functioning, then at least we can provide them with a method of presenting sound through skull vibrations so that way they can hear through bone conduction. And so that's something that can be either surgically implanted or can be done non-surgically as well. Sometimes it can get emotional when you have to tell a parent that their child has hearing loss and they're not being able to hear, but then the flip side or the other side of that is putting a hearing aid in and amplifying that sound. And for the first time that child turns their head to see where that sound is coming from, it's like this overwhelming joy that you see. And then you see the parents getting very excited. Or even I've had patients come back and say, I can hear the blinker in my car when turning the blinker on to make a left turn or a right turn. That response that the individual provides definitely is a rewarding experience for me.